guys, my name is Coaster Charlie, YouTube channel Doncaster born but built for theme park news, and welcome to a theme park predictions video where today we're going to be predicting what I think personally will be the next coaster to come to Six Flags Great Adventure in Chicago, Illinois, and where in the park it could go. Now we've got three potential coaster sites, and we're going to be talking about where these coasters, I'm going to talk about two different coaster types for each site. They could be in the same site, they could be different types. You guys don't know, I know, you guys don't know. But before we get started, guys, please like the video if you've loved it. Please don't comment down below. Make sure you subscribe to the channel for more theme park news, reviews, and vlogs. Please click the notification bell so you never miss a YouTube video. Please share with your friends, your family, and on social media. And make sure you keep getting your video suggestions down below, your shout outs down below, and also your questions, because your questions are going to be very, very helpful for our subscriber Q&A when we celebrate 2,000 subscribers. It can be questions that I've already answered or new questions from scratch. Either way, they're all welcome. But use the hashtag question before or after your question. And for now, guys, let's get into this theme park predictions video. So Six Flags Great America opened on the 29th of May 1976, and it contains 15 roller coasters. But what will be coaster number 16? Well, taking a look through the coaster lineup of Six Flags Great Adventure, among the 15 coasters, they have American Eagle, which is a 1981 Intamin wooden coaster. They have Batman the Ride, which is a 1992 Bologram Mabillard inverted roller coaster. They have Dark Knight, which is a Mack Wild Mouse coaster that opened in 2008. They have the 1976 Arrow Custom Looping coaster, known as Demon. They have a 2014 RMC Topper Track wooden coaster called Goliath. They have Joker, which is a 2017 SNS 4D free spin 110 model. They have the 2010 Philadelphia Toboggan Coasters Junior Coaster Little Dipper, relocated from Kiddyland. They have Max Force, their latest coaster, which is an SNS air launch roller coaster, which opened at the park in 2019. They have Raging Bull, which is a 1999 Bologram Mabillard hyper coaster. They have Sprocket Rockets, which is a Vekoma Junior Coaster, a 207 meter model that opened at the park in 1998. They have Superman Ultimate Flight, which is a Bologram Mabillard flying coaster that opened at the park in 2003. They have Vertical Velocity, which is an Intamin Twist and Spike 56 meter long impulse coaster that opened at the park in 2001. They have a Cyclone Mirror wooden coaster known as Viper that opened at the park in 1995. They also have Whizzer, which is a Schwarzkopf Speed Racer Extender Jumbo Jet that opened in 1976. And finally, they have X-Flight, which is a Bologram Mabillard wing coaster that opened at the park back in 2012. Now, eight coasters at the park have been and gone. Deja Vu, which is a removed Vekoma Giant Inverted Boomerang that last operated in 2007 and first opened in 2001. They had a kids coaster that opened and closed during 1976 called the Gulf Coaster, manufactured by Alan Herschel Company. They have Iron Wolf, which last operated in 2011 and first opened in 1990, which is a Bologram Mabillard stand-up coaster before being relocated to Six Flags America, and then in 2019, a few years after operating as a stand-up coaster, was transformed into a flawless coaster known to this day as Firebird. The park also has Raging Cajun, operated between 2004 and 2013 as Ampella Twister Coaster that relocated to Six Flags America. They had Rolling Thunder, which operated between 1989 and 1995. It was an Intamin Sarajevo Bobsled Swiss Bob Coaster that was relocated from Six Flags Great Adventure and now operates as Alpine Bobsled since 1998 at the Great Escape, another Six Flags theme park. They have an Arrow Custom Looper that opened between 1988 and 2002, known as Shockwave. They've got Tidal Wave, which is their Schwarzkopf weight drop shuttle loop coaster that operated between 1978 and 1991, before being relocated to Ober, Georgia as Viper, before then being relocated to Kentucky Kingdom, where it last operated in 2009 as Greased Lightning. And finally, the park opened Z-Force, an Intamin Space Diver, which is now a defunct coaster model that operates between 1985 and 1987. It was moved to over Georgia as Z-Force before finally operating from 1992 to 2003 as Flashback at Six Flags Magic Mountain before being demolished in 2007. So those, my friends, are the coaster lineup for Six Flags Great America, past and present. Looking back at all the coasters currently at the park, the 15 currently at the park, and the 8 that have been and gone at the park, it's very clear to see that Six Flags Great America had a vast range of coasters in terms of height, length, speed, age range, target audience, and also the type of seating arrangement, the type of track at the park. It's been very, very exciting to watch the history of Six Flags Great America, and long live the future of this theme park. But what are the three sights that I've got for the Six Flags Great America's next roller coaster, in my opinion? Well, let's take a look at that now as we start with Sight A, replacing Demon and the Ricochet Flat Ride. So Sight A occupies the Ricochet Flat Ride and Demon. This coaster opened in 1976 and is an Aerodynamics custom looping coaster. It originally opened as Turn of the Century with two corkscrew loops in 1976 until 1979, and then for the 1980 season was painted black, given the theme of Demon, and added two vertical loops. And during the 2016 season, optional VR goggles could be worn while riding the Demon, creating the Rage of the Gargoyles experience. This ride has a length of 2,130 feet, a height of 103.7 feet, a drop of 90 feet, a speed of 50 miles per hour, 4 inversions in a duration of 1 minute and 45. Now, there's only two types of roller coasters I could see come to this site, and that is a Bologram Mabillard dive coaster and an RMC single rail coaster on the lines of Jersey Devil at Six Flags Great Adventure rather than Wonder Woman Golden Lasso coaster at Six Flags Fiesta Texas. The Rocky Mountain Construction single rail coaster is a unique investment for a theme park, especially with the capacity issue that the prototype models were facing. For bigger parks such as Great America, Great Adventure with their Jersey Devil coaster, and of course Magic Mountain adding a similar coaster for 2021 according to plans released by California State. Great America could add a single rail coaster on the lines of the Jersey Devil that could solve the capacity issue to an extent and also deliver a one-of-a-kind thrill ride that will excite viewers and give the attention to thrill seekers around the world. The other type of coaster is a Bologram Mabillard dive coaster. Now, this has always been long rumoured for Six Flags Magic Mountain, potentially to beat Yukon Striker Statics at Canada's Wonderland. However, could Great America do with a dive coaster? It's one of the many different seating arrangements by Bologram Mabillard Manufacturing that Great America does not have. Along with the Hyper and Wing, this would be a welcome fit to the theme park. Now, Site 2 takes over the Vertical Velocity Coaster, the Yankee Clipper Flat Ride, and also Logger's Run, so it would completely transform that area of the theme park. Now, Vertical Velocity is an Intamin Impulse roller coaster. Now, this was a specific model of Impulse coaster that was known as the Twist and Spike 56 meter model. It opened back on the 18th of May 2001. It is an Intamin Impulse with a length of 630 feet, a height of 185 feet, and a speed of 70 miles per hour, which included a vertical rollback, a twisting vertical rollback, and an LIM multipass launch. Formerly known as V2, the ride also has a capacity of 1,100 riders per hour. As previously mentioned, the Yankee Clipper Flat Ride and Logger's Run would also make way. Now, there are two potential types of coaster that could fit on this site. An RMC single rail pops up again, but the main coaster type I'm focusing on for this site is a Mack Power Splash. If you removed the log flume as well as the vertical velocity in the Yankee Clipper, you could potentially fit a Mack Power Splash in that lake area and theme it really, really well to the surrounding area. Now, you could maybe leave vertical velocity alone and just remove the log flume, and that would still make enough fantastic space for a Power Splash attraction. However, I would bet on all of them being removed, including vertical velocity and the Yankee Clipper, because it would allow more space for landscaping and beautiful scenery that Six Flags have been accustomed to, especially over the last couple of years when it comes to new attractions. The final coaster site up for debate is the site of American Eagle. Now, this is an Intamin wooden roller coaster that opened at the park on the 23rd of May, 1981. It has 4,650 feet length of track on both the red and blue sides, with a height of 127 feet, a drop of 147 feet, a speed of 66 miles per hour, a vertical angle of 55 degrees, a duration of 2 minutes 23, and built by Philadelphia Toboggan Coast International, designed by Curtis D. Summers, and contracted by Figley Wright Contractors, with a capacity of 1,800 riders per hour. This coaster site was an absolute non-brainer and one of the easiest to choose out of the top three options. Now, the American Eagle has been long rumoured for a couple of years now to be getting the RMC treatment. In fact, reports suggest that it was discussed about replacing American Eagle with an RMC coaster before they decided on the Iron Wall site to be replaced by Goliath. Now, American Eagle's refurbishment into an RMC is still being talked about to this day, and I think there's two potential RMC routes that could go down. It's no clue that they're going to potentially go down the Topper Track or Ibox, depending on which they feel best. However, there's only two different routes to go down in terms of what type of RMC coaster they want to add to this park to make it different to their already existing Rocky Mountain Construction coaster, Goliath. One option is a completely dueling coaster. Keep the dueling aspect of the red and blue sides and just add in the brand new RMC track that gives it the modern wooden coaster experience, just like Goliath with its Topper Track wooden coaster layout. Now, the other addition would be to make it a Mobius Loop coaster. Now, a Mobius Loop coaster is traditionally known as a dueling coaster, however, it's known just as one coaster instead of two tracks. That is because the first track joins into the back of the second track, creating an even longer layout but a more thrilling ride experience and the chance to experience both sides of the layout. So that, my friends, is my three coaster sites. So you've got the Vertical Velocity, Yankee Clipper, and Logger's Run site for an RMC single rail coaster or a Mack Power Splash. You've got American Eagle for an RMC Mobius Loop or dueling hybrid coaster. And you've also got that third site replacing the Ricochet Flat Ride and the Arrow Custom Looper Demon. And this would be for a B&M Dive or an RMC single rail coaster. Now, the B&M Dive and the Mack Power Splash are very much my own personal predictions. However, an RMC single rail coaster along the lines of Jersey Devil at Six Flags Great Adventure and an RMC hybrid conversion of American Eagle are both realistic options compared to the B&M Dive and the Mack Power Splash. So I think that all suggestions are very valid. However, it's the single rail and the RMC hybrid treatment of American Eagle that are the most likely. So if I was to rank these in order, I would go third, Vertical Velocity, Yankee Clipper and Logger's Run site. In second place, I would go with the Demon and Ricochet sites, and at number one, I could see RMC American Eagle being the next roller coaster. So using that order, I'm now going to predict years this early as to when these coaster projects will happen. So, RMC American Eagle, I think will happen for the 2023 season. The Demon Ricochet site that comes in at number two in our top three, I predict that to happen for the 2029 season. And then the Yankee Clipper Vertical Velocity and Logger's Run site, I personally think that will happen between 2033 and 2035. So there we go, guys. That is my top three Great America coaster sites for the future and what will replace them and what years they'll be in and things like that. So thank you so much for watching this video. Please give this video a like. Please comment down below. Please subscribe. Click the notification bell so you never miss a YouTube video and more theme park news updates and prediction videos and review videos and vlogs. And for now, guys, I'm Aaron Chaloner from Coaster Chal. Keep living the coaster life, and I'll see you guys in the next video very, very soon. Take care, guys. Have an awesome day.